In 1845, journalist John O. Sullivan used the term manifest destiny to describe the inherent privilege had by Americans to explore and lay claim to the Western frontier. While the validity of this belief is somewhat questionable, it also exposes a rather curious reality about the national perception of the West in the mid-1800s. As evidenced in O'Sullivan's remarks, the frontier was a remarkably desirable place, and despite the obvious dangers it presented, the vast majority of Americans were quite taken by it. However, the West had not been transformed into this romantic idol overnight. It had been rendered so through the work of James Fenimore Cooper. Cooper is widely credited with inventing the great American novel, and his influence on future novelists, combined with his work in shaping the American identity, absolutely secure him a place in the AP US History Hall of Fame. James Fenimore Cooper's legacy began following the War of 1812. Often referred to as the Era of Good Feelings, this time period was characterized by intense nationalism and a common sense of civilian pride in the fledgling United States. However, the country had yet to find a truly representative set of values to define itself. Enter Cooper and his debut novel, The Spy. Published in 1821, it told the story of a heroic patriot fighting alongside George Washington in the Revolutionary War. The first American novel to achieve worldwide acclaim, it catapulted Cooper onto the national scene and established him as the first American to write with a style distinctly different from that seen in Europe. The specific genre employed by Cooper was called historical romance, and it dramatized the events surrounding the American Revolution in a pious, nationalistic vein. This mirrored the national psyche at the time, and was therefore very well received by the public. Incidentally, the writing itself was highly praised, with Victor Hugo calling it the greatest writing of the century. At last, the United States was in possession of a talented writer who was distinctly American, but Cooper had only just begun to make his mark on the national identity. In response to the fame achieved by the Spy's romanticism, Cooper began work on The Pioneers, a novel chronicling a family's journey into the New York State frontier. Utilizing a similar style to his previous work, Cooper's first Leather Stocking Tale portrayed frontiersmen as American nobility and thus galvanized the American public. Showcasing the power of the common man in his natural environment, Cooper painted Americans as bold, daring, and resourceful, and his popularity ensured that they would be seen as such throughout the world. Moving farther and farther from its British roots, the United States had become a society of ardent individualists, and James Fenimore Cooper was at the center of it. In addition, The Pioneers introduced the character Natty Bumppo, who quickly became the archetypal American hero. He embodied the qualities Cooper so staunchly advocated, and other characters modeled off Bumppo continue to populate American literature. In Melville, Thoreau, and Twain, Cooper's writings and characters are clearly emulated, leaving no doubt to his impact on American literature. Still, Cooper's influence didn't end with his writing. As the American identity became increasingly associated with democratic ideas, such as that of the common man, so too did American politics. In 1828, Cooper's message had become so popular in American society that Andrew Jackson, running on a platform of agrarian, individualist democracy, won in a landslide. While it was Jackson's beliefs and likability that endeared him to voters, it was Cooper's romanticism of democratic ideals that made such popularity possible. Without Cooper, the American identity may have been vastly different, altering social and political structures for generations. After living briefly as an expatriate in France, as well as studying naval history in the United States, Cooper returned to writing in the genre he knew best. In the 1840s, he wrote two more leather stocking tales, including his masterpiece, The Last of the Mohicans, thereby cementing his legacy as champion of the great American novel. By the late 1840s, Cooper's career was winding down and his health had begun to fail as well. In 1851, Cooper died and was memorialized in an event attended by Daniel Webster, William Cullen Bryant, and Washington Irving, among others. Even after his death, though, Cooper's impact is still felt. That same year, Nathaniel Hawthorne published The Scarlet Letter, a novel that many hailed as a continuation of Cooper's established American identity. At the same time, Herman Melville published Moby Dick, a highly romanticized sea novel of the type first made popular by Cooper. Even in the 20th century, novels such as Gone with the Wind, The Grapes of Wrath, and To Kill a Mockingbird owe their existence to the great American novel that Cooper made possible. Ultimately, Cooper's impact is not measured in economic upheaval or shocking political turmoil. It isn't measured in radical protests or brutal military feats. It is measured in how American society came to be defined in the early 1800s, and how in the span of a single lifetime, one man altered the identity of a nation from one strictly European to something uniquely American. That man is James Fenimore Cooper, and for these accomplishments, he deserves your vote to the APUS History Hall of Fame. Thank you.